What is the street parking vault? What started as the Monday retest workout turned into the weekly vault workout. The vault is a one workout a week for 25 weeks series with new workouts each year.
Now the goal of the street parking vault is to help you guys build consistency by completing all 25 vault workouts within a 6-month period.
You can customize the movements in these workouts and choose any variation that fits your abilities.
Your scores and weights do not matter.
The goal is to maintain consistency from week to week.
Remember, you just can't
miss.
Week 13 of the vault, we're gonna tackle Loki today. I'll be doing the extra challenge reps with the barbell. I'm gonna go, it does say 115 plus, I'm gonna go 125 based off of the coach's reactions in here. They scared me into not going heavier. So I hope that it's gonna go better. Rachel's gonna be doing the sandbag version for this, and she might make an adjustment based off of how her wrist is feeling later on in the workout. So if you guys do see that change, it's because she has wrist issues, okay? Make sure you guys stick to the end of this vault for all my tips, as well as if you guys need to see more of the detailed movements or any of the written description, go to my.streetparking.com.
We're counting down.
Oh my God, they're starting.
3, 2, 1. And we are off. Loki, Alex, I'm so excited to watch these guys do this workout.
Why are you so excited, Jeb?
Well, because I think Loki is a great character, and I think the workout really reflects the essence of Loki. And
so it's not because they have to blame you for it.
that might be part of it. I like to think that everything is a group effort.
Nice. So tell me, what is Loki? What are they doing?
Okay, so it's a little bit complex, so you got to make sure that you're very familiar with how it's going to go down. But you're going to start with 3 rounds of 2 wall walks and 6 of the Loki complex. Then you rest 1 minute, go into 2 rounds of 3 wall walks and 9 of the Loki complex, rest 1 minute, and then finally you finish with 1 single round of 6 wall walks and 18 Loki complex. Now, Alex, can you tell the good people what a Loki complex is?
Absolutely, Jeb. So a Loki complex, 1 rep, is 1 deadlift, 1 power clean, and 1 squat clean. So 3 pulls off the floor will get you 1 Loki complex.
That is correct. And obviously, you guys, be smart, be safe. But the intention behind the Loki complex is you do all of those movements without taking your hands off the bar. So it's the deadlift, power clean, and squat clean all in one fluid motion without taking your hands off the bar or the dumbbells or the sandbag.
Right, and as you can see, Julian's strategy looks like he is starting off with singles, so it's perfectly fine to break after the squat clean before the next start of the deadlift for the next rep. And I think at the weight that he's using and the caliber of athlete, just him knowing himself, the bar is going to settle right as soon as it hits the ground. He can grab it, start working on the next rep. Otherwise, if you're using the dumbbells, if you're using the sandbag, we do think it's worth hanging on to your weight for at least 2, if not 3 reps at a time before taking a break.
Yeah, it's a lot of this is going to come down to the weight that you use. And this may be a little deceptive, which is why I feel like it really fits Loki, because just because you're able to string some reps together and things are really going good in those first 3 rounds, I'll tell you right now, this workout comes down to that final round of the 18 Loki complexes.
Yeah, the structure of this workout isn't something, well, unless you're new to street parking, but this is a rep scheme that we've done before where
sure.
we'll break up, you know, a bigger set into its more manageable into half and then into thirds. Usually, though, what you'll see is that one round of higher reps is at the beginning, and then we break it up as we go. We decided to reverse that this round, and makes it even more daunting, I think, to
Absolutely.
Finish with those big sets.
Yeah.
It actually speaks to, I think, just programming in general and, like, the art of it, you know? Like, if all we did was just flip this around, it would be a totally different workout. Mentally.
Oh, completely.
Yeah, you would just be ready to take on that third part, knowing that you're only doing two wall walks at a time, only six Loki complex at a time, and you're getting that mental and physical break moving between movements instead of having
right.
to stay on one thing for a long period of time.
So let's talk about Rachel here and the sandbag. She has opted to go sandbag, which generally is going to be a little bit lighter than if you were to do a barbell version.
Yeah.
Maybe some of you guys are working with a heavier bag. But it does change things a little bit. You can see she can hold on to that sandbag, and she's putting together several reps at a time like you were talking about.
Yeah.
However, that is definitely going to keep that heart rate nice and high.
Yeah, I don't know if the trade-off is worth it. I mean, maybe it is. Yeah, and I remember, so we tested this one because it is a new movement for the street parking community. We wanted to make sure it was appropriate. And when it came to counting, first off, I do recommend practicing a few reps of the complex in the warm-up. Because it does take a little bit of time to kind of get into a rhythm, get into a flow, to remember, okay, after that deadlift, I go to the shoulders. After I go to the shoulders, I go through the squat. And I found it helped to count which rep I was on for each part of the complex. So, for instance, when I deadlifted, I would count one. When I power cleaned, one. When I squat cleaned, one. And then when I got to the second rep, it was two, 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 three, 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 so on and so forth. I found that kind of helped keep me like mentally engaged and focused, so I didn't lose track of where I was.
Yeah. Yeah. Find something that's going to work for you so that you don't expend a bunch of mental energy trying to figure out how many reps you've done. Now, you can see Rachel's already starting on the part two. So she's going three wall walks, nine Loki complex. I should also mention that Julian, he's now in his break. He is doing not only the extra challenge weight, but also the reps. So he's doing more wall walks each time as well. So it is going to take a little bit longer if you do go that extra challenge route, just
yeah.
because you're doing more volume and more load.
Yeah, for sure.
So they're both back at it. Now they're kind of like, you know, they got a feel for how this workout's going. You're in the middle section, slightly more reps. But again, I'm just really excited to see what the 18
yeah.
look like at the end.
Yeah.
Alex, what is the shift version?
That's a great question, Jeb. Shift is three sets. Each set is a four-minute AMRAP, so that's as many rounds and reps as possible in 4 minutes. You'll cycle through two inchworms, four deadlifts, four hang power cleans, and then four either dumbbell or goblet squats. And then once those 4 minutes are up, you'll rest for 1 minute before starting the next set. And actually, with shift, we obviously there's maybe a little bit more freedom. We don't necessarily anticipate you guys going unbroken from the deadlifts through to the squats, but one of the neat things about this complex or these movements is that the previous one leads into the next. So when you're finished with that fourth deadlift, you're there, you're ready, you can go right into the hang power cleans. After the fourth hang power clean, the weight's at your shoulders, you can go right into the squats. So if you choose your weight wisely and pace yourself well, you could kind of turn that into a little bit of a Loki complex.
A little
almost.
Mini Loki complex.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then the other thing you can do is like do three deadlifts, rest, get your fourth deadlift. Now you're in position for the hang power cleans, Same thing with the hang power cleans. You take a break, then you get your fourth hang power clean. You're in position for the squats.
Absolutely.
And so you can have some fun with how you decide to rest during that.
So, Jeb, Julian mentioned in the intro that we might see Rachel change up her wall walks because of a wrist injury. What are some options in case maybe someone can't do a wall walk for whatever reason? What other options do they have?
Yeah, so it really depends on the nature of what you're, you know, if you're trying to accommodate for some sort of an injury, then everyone's going to be slightly different. Rachel just has like a minor little wrist thing that she felt when we tested this a while back, and she felt it later on in the workout. So something as simple as just going from a wall walk to like a push-up plus tap might be just fine. You're still putting pressure on the wrist, but it's just not like the vertical force of your entire body down on the wrist. You have that horizontal plank, so it takes a lot of the pressure off. Now, for some people, that might not be enough. So you could do hands on the dumbbells or something like that and with
push-up. Maybe even elevated. Elevated might just take some loading off.
And absolutely. Yeah, and so that would be a way to modify the customization of push-up plus taps.
Yeah.
Now, in terms of other customizations, in turn, you know, just like maybe the wall walk is strength-wise a little bit too much, and you're losing stability in the shoulders and things like that. The pike walkout, or even just an inchworm, and you can kind of play with bridging the gap between shift and Loki, like do a difficult version of an inchworm or something like that. So there's a whole sort of continuum from a wall walk all the way down to an inchworm or a push-up. Mm-hmm. And you can find something on that continuum that's going to work for you.
Absolutely. So let's talk about the Loki complex a little bit. One thing that as coaches we see sometimes with cleans, specifically squat cleans, is a shortening of the upward drive. So as we, you know, raise the weights up from the floor, whether it's dumbbells, sandbag, barbell, not opening up the hips all the way, not standing up tall before dropping under the bar. So make sure that you guys are taking the time. It may seem inefficient, but it really will save you over the course of the, you know, however many, how many reps did we figure?
54.
54 Loki complex, so.
And each Loki complex essentially is three reps. So you can do the math on 3 times 54. You got 162 pulls from the floor today.
Yeah.
That's a lot.
That's a lot.
If you're getting sloppy, you're going to pay for it.
Yeah, at some point.
Yeah, and not in like the cool I'm so sore way. It's like the my back, spinal, right? So you don't want that. All right, so Huyen is in his second break, and I believe that Rachel
is starting
her final round. So they're making good time here. I think they're both right on pace for landing somewhere in that goal range, which is perfect.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I mean, apart from just the time it takes to transition from movement to movement in those earlier parts where there's multiple rounds, the work is the same, right? The total number of reps per part is the same. So it makes sense that their times should be similar if they pace this correctly. Hopefully we don't see a huge drop-off, but that's also very possible, right? That last, like mentally even just getting back to that bar and doing 18 reps, oof, that's rough.
Yeah, and so I think now might be a good time to talk about Loki, who Loki was and how it's appropriate for this. So Loki was, I would say, he's a trickster, and he was the most annoying of all of the gods, half god, half giant. He didn't really fall into any one category, never felt totally at home anywhere.
He was like a black sheep.
He was like the black sheep, right? And so he played lots of tricks on people, and he was very deceptive, and he was very fluid in how he could change, you know, everything about him.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And so
you might call him manipulating.
Very
manipulative.
Manipulative. And so I think that this workout is going to be quite deceptive for a lot of people.
Yeah, and I think even when you were thinking of the Loki complex, Loki being a shapeshifter, you
right.
can see how these movements are kind of shifting in their shape and building on one another.
Right.
I'm going to introduce you to a word, Jeb, that we use back home.
Ooh, I can't wait.
It's a Cajun French word, and it's canaille.
Canaille.
Which is like mischievous and conniving. And
uh-huh, okay.
So if you were canaille, it was kind of a little bit of an insult. It was, or a reprimand even, maybe uh-huh. from your parents. Yeah, yeah. So Loki was canaille in all sense of the word.
I love it.
Yeah.
Was that word directed towards you in your
no,
childhood?
No, I wasn't. I wasn't so much. I did show a bull for 4-H 1 year and named it canaille, and
uh-huh.
and he definitely he embodied that trait for sure.
Nice.
But no, I was a good kid.
I'm sure. So it looks like Rachel went through with all the wall walks. She felt okay and was able to.
Yeah, I'm stoked for her because
yeah.
I know that was she was kind of concerned about that. So that's awesome. I see a little bit of a
little raspberry there.
Yeah, I see that sandbag's kind of taking a beating on her.
But she's just so close.
Oh yeah, she's crushing. She looks like she's staying real steady.
Now, I do notice that the expression on Julian's face has changed a little bit.
hopefully Salvi gets a little close-up on that.
Not quite as jovial as he was at the beginning.
No. I think maybe he'll be grateful that we discouraged him from doing 135.
We talked to
him,
yeah. Yes.
I think here, I was just going to say, I think here is a good time mentally, maybe set your rest to like a certain number of breaths, because I think it can get really daunting after a while and you end up resting longer than maybe you need to. So it might be helpful, you know, drop your weight and then 3 deep breaths and you're back on it.
Yeah, you got to have something to keep you mentally locked in, because it's so much effort. You're going to feel like it's so much effort to just get 1 rep. And then you're going to be like, oh, that's 4. Oh, that's 5.
Yeah.
Okay, I still have 13 more
yeah.
of these to go.
Yeah.
And so it feels very insurmountable at some point during that set of 18. So you got to have something mentally that's just going to keep you grinding, keep you moving forward,
nice.
And not worry so much about like how much you've got left. It's just 1 rep at a time. Take your rest. Get right back to it.
So Rachel just wrapped up about 15:40 on the clock or so. So just under the goal time, that's excellent. Especially with the sandbag, like we mentioned, it's relatively lighter of all the program versions for most people. So that's great. I'm glad that she was able to knock that out just under the goal time.
Yeah, and so I actually had Rachel test this one, and she tested it with 30-pound dumbbells.
Wow.
And so in convincing her to be the person that we're actually, you know, showing the workout
yeah,
of.
And with Julian.
And with Julian, I said, yeah, you can go sandbag on this one. You've put in,
so
you
kind
paid
of
your
you.
Dues.
Wow.
Wow. Okay, that's very impressive.
That was incredible. 16:31 for Julian.
Dang.
Which, you know, I'm glad we kind of fitness bullied him into a little bit more than extra challenge, but not quite what
yeah.
he was thinking.
Yeah.
Because it just goes to show you, he still finished on the fast end of the goal time with more wall walks, with heavier load.
Uh-huh.
He crushed that. That was impressive.
That's really insane. As somebody who has done this workout, wow. So I am very excited to hear what his tips are and how mm-hmm. he reflects on this workout.
Mm-hmm. All right. So, depending on what version you do, I would say if you're doing barbell, singles is the way to go from the get-go. Because remember, you're holding on to the complex. So choose a weight that allows you to do that. Don't go heavier just because you feel like you can do it. use the warm-up to figure out what that comfortable weight looks like. Singles was the way to go for me, honestly. And if anything, just speed that up in the round of 18, because you're just stuck there. There's no break to go do another movement. You want to make sure you're saving your energy for that last push there. So slow down your pacing on the first three round section there, and then stick to your flow on that second section there for the two rounds, and then start gradually, you know, either you're holding your pace or you're picking up towards the last eight reps, because one movement takes quite a bit. Make sure you guys are warming up your lower back, open up the hips, you know, really get a good stretch and a good warm up, because if not, your lower back, this could really set you up for your lower back to get super tight. Luckily, the Loki complex, because it pushes you to hold on to that barbell, you're always stacking yourself in a good position to finish that complex there. So that saves you a bit, but don't get sloppy. What else? On the wall walks, slow it down. Again, that's like a nice little break, to be honest. So that way you can push through on the Loki complex. That's it, those are my tips. If you're doing sandbag, dumbbell version, try to hold on to at least two to three complexes at a time, nothing more than that. Break, catch your breath, and keep moving. All right, have fun with that one. Ouch.
Welcome to week 13 of the 2022 Vault. Today we are tackling Loki. Program B is three rounds of two wall walks and six barbell Loki complexes. Rest for 1 minute. Then two rounds of three wall walks and nine barbell Loki complexes. Rest for 1 minute. And finally, one round of six wall walks and 18 barbell Loki complexes. The score for this workout is the total time it takes you to complete the work, and the goal is between 16 and 20 minutes. Do not go crazy with the first or even first two rounds or parts of this workout. It's all gonna come down to that last round with the big set of six wall walks and 18 of the Loki complexes. Remember, for each one of those complex lifts, you're gonna be pulling from the ground. So really focus on your setup position. You do not need to fly through each one of those reps or the complex movements. In fact, if you can find a smooth and steady pace working on good position, it's gonna save you in the long run. Now come up with your game plan for how you're gonna break up those reps, but just remember that we do not want to break up the complex itself. You can pause in between each one of those reps or however you need to do that. Think maybe 1 to 2 sets in the first round and then slightly more sets as you go on through this workout. For your wall walks, make sure that you are customizing or pacing yourself so that you're able to complete 2 to 3 reps in a minute at the most. If that's not happening for you for whatever reason, then choose a different customization option so that you get the full intended stimulus of this awesome workout. For all of the detailed demos of these movements and the customization options, head on over to my.streetparking.com. Welcome to week 13 of the 2022 Vault. Today we are tackling Loki. Today's shift workout is three sets of a 4 minute AMRAP. That's as many rounds and reps as possible of 2 inchworms, 4 dumbbell deadlifts, 4 dumbbell hang power cleans, and 4 dumbbell squats or goblet squats. Rest for 1 minute in between each set. The score for this workout is the total number of rounds completed across all three sets, and the goal is at least 9 to 12 rounds.
choose a customization and a pace for the inchworm that allows you to complete all of those reps in 30 seconds at the most. Now, also, try to remember to breathe throughout the entire range of motion. It's really kind of tempting to hold your breath as you're walking out into that plank position or through the push-up, but that's gonna really cause a lot more fatigue over time. Now, for the other three movements, the idea here is to kind of flow without needing to stop from one movement to the next. So choose a load or an object that's gonna allow you to complete those movements without needing to stop so much. So that might mean that you're going a little bit lighter on your deadlift or a little bit heavier on your squat, but choose something that you could do all three of the movements with the same object. It doesn't mean that it all needs to be unbroken, but just that it could be if you wanted it to. For all of the detailed demos of these movements and the customization options, head on over to my.streetparking.com.